Sorry?
Wee!
I beg your pardon?
Wee! What are you doing tonight?
Mate, I'm going to the bush today. Oh, excuse me, who's that? I am.
Why are you going home?
Got country music festival.
But that's not at the bush, that's in Tamworth.
What do you think Tamworth is?
Tamworth?
What?
Tamworth is Tamworth.
That's the bush.
Is it close to Walker?
50 minutes from Walker.
Oh, so you'll stay at home? Well, will you check on... Are we recording? No. Oh, we are. Perfect.
Oh, okay.
We're going.
Oh, we've started, have we?
We've started, but will you check on Brown Eye? You didn't ask your dad how he's going. That's my sheep for everyone wondering who we're talking
about.
Fuck,
I didn't ask dad how he's going.
You are an idiot. No, Jack, it's just... I think we cut his throat.
It's a killer. I think we...
Shut your mouth when you're speaking to me. You know what your to-do list isn't doing? It's not doing. Because I told you to do it and you didn't put it on the to-do list.
That wasn't on my... I don't think that was on my to-do list. Let me check my to-do list. What have I got on it?
I thought you could survive without getting checked for ADHD, but I think the time's come where you...
Get leather and sweat. I got some...
Get to check your ADHD,
well,
champ.
Steph has been pushing me to do that for the longest of times. But, you know, it's $1,200. I don't give enough of a fuck.
I think your life would be a lot easier.
If what?
I don't know.
I took some ADHD medication the other day.
Perfect. So now you're doing illegal narcotics.
That's not legal, is it?
Well, they're not for you.
Yeah, I mean, if it's not prescription, then...
Well,
who'd you get them from?
Well, I don't want to say.
Yeah, that's why don't you want to say?
Well, I did. Well, I'm not snitching. Someone gave me them. They were like, these are really strong ones, so take half. And I'm like...
So you double dropped?
So cute. Drilled one. Sort of balanced me, like made me like this. You know what I mean? Just like a straight line. Didn't get like road rage and shit, but I was kind of whatever. But let me tell you something. The next day, I'm not even joking.
Oh.
I've never been so depressed in my life.
I remember that.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
I was fucked.
Yeah, and I was like, don't worry, I'll pep you up this podcast. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Sad little boy.
I was fucked. Honestly, I've never felt like that in my life. And I was like, oh, fuck.
Well, that's because most people would take them like every day, you know?
I know. But yeah. Then I'm like, well, fuck that.
Yeah, but then you get used to it because you're taking it every day.
Nah.
It'd be like brushing your teeth. You know?
Yeah, I do know.
Because you do it every day.
I know.
Well, do you? Well. Speaking of teeth, great segue, Louisa, in Breakfast Radio.
How would you know anything about Breakfast Radio? You wouldn't know a fucking thing about Breakfast
Radio. Jake, I, Laura Delden, worked.
What? Nah. Sorry. We can't.
Not today.
We can't continue this fucking joke forever.
I think my wizzy teeth are coming through. The back line on that side is so sore and tender. I've got a coleslaw as well. It's fucked.
You got a what? You got a what?
An ulcer. Oh, it's a fucking ulcer. Yeah. Ulcer.
There we go.
Coleslaw.
Coleslaw. I've got an
ulcer.
That's
what I was thinking. I was thinking of KFC coleslaw.
Yeah.
Look, Judge just knocked himself out. That's karma for being an asshole.
This is a real...
But I'm going to Melbourne tomorrow, but... Oh, today. Oh, yeah, because we're recording.
You did what I always do.
Damn it. I'm going to Melbourne tomorrow, but I'd quite like to get into the dentist today.
So why do you think your wisdom teeth are coming through?
Well, it's aching up the top, and I've had this before about a year and a half ago. You know how just one can come through?
It explains your lack of wisdom. They haven't come through. This explains a lot.
Most people get their wisdom taken out, Jack.
But yours hasn't even come. Well, so we get the dose of wisdom and then we remove it.
No,
yours has never.
It's coming through. I can feel it.
Really?
Little pointies.
Dude, it is. Have you had any of them out? Your wisdom teeth?
No, I just said they're coming through.
But they can come through at different times, can't they?
Well, the left one's come through a lot better than the right one.
Dude, it's a... I think I need to get them out today.
Get them out today, but I think I need to go to the dentist. You know, Franco was obviously a dentist. Anytime I message him being like, hey, where are my tooth? I guarantee you, should I send him a text right now? I'll go, hey, I think my wisdom tooth is coming through. What should I do? He'll go, hot water and salt. hot, salty mouthwash.
Bro.
I'm going to text him right now.
Mum used to make it whenever there was like a cut in your mouth or whatever, or like fucking ulcer or whatever. Mum would make us gargle salt water. It's the rankest shit. It'd make me spew. I go, sorry about that.
Oh, you want to call Franco?
Yeah, not a great sound to come through.
You want to call Franco?
Call Franco.
You know, I got LDD from Franco. He calls himself FDD.
FDD.
Hello.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, I'm in the car, so that's. Can you hear me all right?
Oh, we don't like you on speakerphone. You're on the podcast, hands free.
Well, I'm actually working. Yeah, hands free and then in the car.
Naughty. We're working as well. We're working hard. But I was just calling because I think my wisdom tooth is coming through on the right side. What should I do?
Well, remember the hot, salty mouthwashes? Have you tried that?
That's what I said you'd say. I said I knew. Yeah. I know. You'll either say colloidal silver or you'll say hot, salty mouthwash. Yeah.
What the fuck's colloidal silver?
It's always a good start.
Yeah.
How are you, Franco?
Yeah, I'm well, mate. I'm well.
Mate, good, thank you. Mate, I've got a slight ulcer on my cheek. What should I do?
Is it on the inside of your cheek?
Correct.
Yeah, so is it because you've bitten something or is it some fruit or something acidic that you've eaten?
I would argue it might be because I'm mildly run down.
Mm.
Yeah. That's probably true as well. Again, I would hit it with the hot, salty mouthwash.
There you go.
The colloidal. Seriously, it makes such a difference.
There you okay, go.
Good. And I'm not talking just a little, you know, mouthful. You get some hot water, as hot as you can stand it. You put a little bit of salt in it. If you haven't got anything like that, it doesn't really matter. It just helps. But and it's just holding it over the area, counting to 10, spitting it out. Okay. Put another mouthful in, hold it over the area, count to 10, spit it out.
Sounds like one of my Saturday nights, Franco.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Perfect. Well, I know what I'll be doing after the podcast. Christ. Hot, salty mouthwash. Thanks,
yeah,
Dad.
Hot, salty mouthwash, Luke.
Thanks so
You're
much.
You're bloody good to us, mate. Thanks, Franco.
Ciao, ciao.
See you guys.
Hey, everybody.
Bye.
I told you. That's exactly what he'd say.
Hot, salty mouthwash. I wanted to see if we could push him like, mate, I've got a sty. In one of my eyes.
What do you reckon?
I think just hot, salty mouthwash, bit of hot water, as hot as you can bear it, and a bit of salt, just a pinch of salt.
Now, we'll have to cut that entire phone call because he was on speakerphone.
You're a coward, Delvin.
Just kidding. The big FDD stays.
So that's where you got LDD from?
Yeah, because Franco would name everything around the house. Like, he'd write on the bottom of his socks, FDD, because, like, my brothers would steal them, and his, like, notepads would be FDD.
Fuck, I've got to start fucking doing that.
Well, Steph's not stealing your socks.
Bro, are you serious?
Actually, you have told me this.
Yeah.
I just had this image just popped into my head.
Pop it.
Like, I was like, that's so Raven.
Pop it.
Of you at home doing a little puppet show behind the couch for Steph with your socks. Ding, 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 ding.
It's not out of my wheelhouse.
It's not too far-fetched.
Yeah.
Like, I think you might see a sock and go, hey, this is a fun idea. Ding, bing, 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 bing.
Yeah. That maybe reminds me of a red light, green light. So, but not that we're going to do that now. I'm just going to write that down because.
Well, while you're writing that down, I've got a phenomenal story for you.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know how you told the story about the penis flytrap?
Yep.
Of your friend who has the big foreskin.
Stubby, large foreskin.
Yep, and he collects flies. He waits
with
for
his foreskin.
So, off the back of that, one of your friends DM'd me.
Oh, fuck.
And said that at university.
Oh, no.
The boys used to play a game. And it would be like a game show, and they'd go, what's in the 40? And at one point, there was 15 $1 coins in the foreskin. There was a little soldier army toy in the foreskin.
That's right. And I actually forgot about it.
My personal favourite, Jarch, a Samsung. But you could see it. So it wasn't much of a guessing game because the Samsung was sticking out of the foreskin.
Oh, shit.
Like, what the fuck is wrong with you guys? What's in the 40? What's in the 40?
Well, I mean, you don't think that's fun? Imagine a little army toy. 15 $1 coins. Now, that's some 40. Skin.
That's a big 40.
It's a sick skin.
Why yeah. don't we go live and we play that game with the bedwetters?
That's a great idea.
It's a wonderful idea.
Dior and I cannot participate. Willie B, can you participate?
Yeah.
Oh, great.
Okay,
we've
got Willie B. We got Willie. What's in the 40?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look, that was probably one of those games where it's you're sitting around one of those iconic green-rimmed glass tables.
Yep.
You know, towards
those
maybe the
old chairs.
Old chairs.
Those
old sort of canvas chairs around them. And then people would find different. The Samsung is pretty wild.
Well, the person who told, I'm going to name who told me. Who do you think it was?
Ed Liston.
Yep. Bang. Jackpot. He said the Samsung was popping out.
Yeah.
But also,
halfway
it was
through.
Years ago, so they were little back then, remember? It's not like you got an iPhone
like
size.
It's not like a Samsung Galaxy. Yeah, but still, it would have looked like a Burmese python halfway through its meal.
Yes, and also would hate to use that phone again.
Yeah, correct.
I think I
threw that one away.
Awesome. Your mum calls. Hello, sorry.
So, mate.
Hey.
So, yeah, Jimbo, just gotta pop my Samsung out of your foreskin for a second. Hey, Ma, how you going? Yeah, you just fucked one of the greatest things I've ever seen. All right, we'll chat later. Bye. Yeah, I mean,
what's in the 40?
You know, but some wild shit goes on at uni.
Oh yeah, I had a couple DMs asking me to talk about my days at Dunedin University.
Okay, does anything spring to mind?
Well, obviously there's the chipped tooth story.
Fuck me dead, for the, 40th time? Oh. You got one yarn from uni. I chipped my tooth.
Judge?
Dad's a dentist.
I grinded on savages, remember?
You didn't grind on, that was some fuck, that's some fuckery. Now
grind one time. We'll beat this. But one time I and my mum had to come pick me up.
No, you
beat
don't need
that. I've got a clean image, Dior.
You don't have a climage.
I've got a climage.
You don't have a climage.
I've got a nice array of clean, chic, and ghastly.
No, you attempt to be clean and chic.
I am chic.
No. Let me. You are chic. Aesthetically chic. Internally. Not personality-wise, not chic.
Am I like a chic bogan?
You're a shogun.
Okay. But cut that, Dior. Jill will be furious.
Well, clearly she already knows about it.
Yeah, she
yeah,
picked
no
you
shit.
Up.
She's going to get me.
Yeah, so it's fine.
It was my first time.
Mate, everyone experiments a little bit. You know, one of my mates, Streety, Hamish Street, good old boy. We were walking home from a night downtown once.
No, you were not walking home.
No, that's the yarn.
Oh my.
Yeah, we were like still with our feet.
What? No, were you wearing shoes?
Yeah, I promise you.
Oh my, you're a very good storyteller.
Thank you.
That.
What other yarns have you got?
Well, Jack, I'm not sure if I told you, but I ate 3 sausages once.
Please tell that again.
So it was a pork
get
and
fucked.
Fennel.
So me and Streety were walking home, right? And we'd had a good night. We were fucking blind.
Yeah.
Streety is one of the most clumsy fellas. I don't know if I've spun this yarn about horses. Anyway, we'll give it another nudge. Streety and I are walking home by ourselves. We sort of were like, we're over it. Let's go back to the college and drink. Anyway, we find a trolley. As you do.
Mm.
And he's like, get in. And I'm like, he got in first. I'm like, woohoo, woohoo. He's like, my turn. And I know how clumsy he is. I'm like, Streety, just don't tip it over. Please don't tip it over. He's like, yeah, no, bro, I won't. It's all good. So I'm in the trolley and we're running down the road into the college. And I'm like, woohoo. And we're going pretty fast. Anyway, front left wheel hits like a little pothole. Boom. I'm flung out of the trolley. And I'm like, fucking hell. I'm like, Streety. He's like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm like, it's okay, buddy. Anyway, I'm dusting myself off and look to the left and there's a couple of horses in a paddock.
Nay.
Yeah, yes, there was.
Just adding sound effects to your story.
Thank you so much.
Just making it a bit better.
That actually changed the game.
Thanks.
Streety goes, should we go ride those horses? And I'm like, yeah, fucking oath. So we climb over the fence into the paddock. There's these two horses and we're sort of approaching them. But then we hear like people coming back sporadically from downtown back to the college. And Streety and I were like, we don't want to share this experience with anyone. This is a special thing between you and I to ride these horses. So we'd hide
in the long grass
and we'd wait for people like the drunkards to like walk down. And once they'd pass, we'd get back up and we're like, okay, how do we approach this? There was two horses. We're going to have to ride them bareback. And Streety was like, fuck. He goes, there's no time like the present. Jumps up onto a horse, starts riding it around. I'm like, fuck yeah. I jump up on the other horse and we're just riding these horses around this paddock, having so much fun. People would then, we'd hear people, we'd jump off the horses, hide in the grass, and be like, just wait, just wait. The people would leave, then we just ride these horses around.
And the horses didn't do anything?
They were great. They were so placid. It was unreal.
So you held on to their manes?
Yeah.
You were bareback riding?
Yeah.
Brokeback Mountain?
I beg your pardon? Wasn't the only bareback riding I did that night, let me tell you.
That is illegal.
Well, it was illegal.
What were the horses doing there for the police? You know how the police ride them around Centennial?
No, they just, some bloke owned a couple of horses.
Mm. I rode a horse when I was 8 called Paddy.
Fucking poor thing.
And I started crying.
Jesus Christ. You started crying?
Yeah.
It would have whinnied its way to the grave.
No, Judge, it was a tiny horse as well. Like, they could have picked a bigger one for old LDD.
Really?
Yeah, I remember being like, sitting on it.
You cried?
I cried. What? I haven't been on a horse since, Paddy.
Look,
I thought you were.
No. Jesus, you're becoming more me than me.
Well, I know where your brain goes now.
Yeah. We were never a big horse family growing up. Like, you know, there's horsey families.
I went to a horse riding school.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is weird because I think mum and dad wanted me to get into the horse riding.
Yeah.
And all the girls, like, because it was like, you know, Saturdays and Sundays were spent down at the bloody stables and, you know, riding the horses.
Look, it's a lot of admin.
But I was more into my drama, speech and, you know, Shakespeare, speech and drama, acting.
Speech and drama, acting. Yeah.
I know everyone thinks I'm a terrible actress.
You are.
But you don't win the Shakespeare bloody Sheila win.
We've got a fucking.
You don't win the Shakespeare Sheila win award,
bro,
when you're a shit actress.
I reckon you've fair dinkum had three things happen in your life and you just spin them over and over again.
What?
I chopped my tooth at uni. I actually won an award for Shakespeare. I'm a great singer. Rinse and repeat, kid.
Hey, there's four.
What?
I worked in Breakfast Radio, champion.
What? No, you're good, aren't you?
I'm very clever, aren't I?
But I think uni is probably pretty. I went to Charles Sturt University in Bathurst, and I know it's certainly it's changed a tremendous amount in probably what? When the fuck did I leave? Fucking 2012. Wow, 2012. I left.
When would I have left then?
That's up to you, buddy. That's, you know that better than all of us. So,
well,
so me leaving uni had zero effect.
I'm how many years younger than you? Four.
Four.
So I would have left in 2016?
16
or 17.
Yeah, true.
Depending how long my degree was.
Yeah, wow. Okay. And then what, you were working at Nova in 2000, so 2 years later?
No, because I lived in New Zealand, you dumb fuck.
Oh, yeah.
So I worked in Brick.
Yeah, but that was still right.
Seriously.
But that was still right. Then you were working at Nova 2 years, 2 years odd later.
No, because I worked in New Zealand after uni for 4 years.
So you wouldn't have finished in 2017 because you were working at Nova in 2019.
No, I wasn't. I was working at Nova in end of 2020. I worked at SCA before Nova.
I thought we only missed each other by about fucking 6 months.
No, I was at HIT Today FM night show with Danny Lakey, remember?
Gotcha. Yeah, I do.
And they called me Shoey Louie. Have I ever told you? No,
we've
Jake.
We've never heard that before either.
My party trick is to drink out of shoes.
Is it? Would you drink out of those shoes?
Not my Dior's.
What about those $1,100 joggers that you got?
These are more, champ.
No, they're not. This is why it goes back to my theory that fashion is for suckers.
You're wearing $900 R.M. Williams.
$700, got them for free.
You'd pay that anyway.
But these are handcrafted leather.
Yeah,
boots.
I like sneakers. It's my thing.
Yeah, but what I'm
don't
saying.
Don't tell me how to live my life.
I'll have these for 12.
I'll have
to
these
15
for 12
years.
For 15 years.
They're filthy already.
You're filthy.
No. Don't get defensive about your dumb little fucking decisions.
Hey, why have we still got our I know why we've still got our headphones on. We're playing a new game, aren't we, Dior? Ding, ding, ding. New game alert. Bing, bing. Game alert.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm
so
excited.
So I
as
came
well.
Up with this in the car. It's an old radio gag.
So I count. Yeah, okay.
So I thought, I was listening to that cool playlist I was listening to, which has all the funky songs.
Yep.
And I was like, let's play a game where we have our headphones on and Dior plays the first, like, a song, and we've got to yell out what the song is first.
Okay.
So he'll play five songs and you just yell it out. You don't say Judge, you don't say Lou. You yell out what the song is.
Okay, so have you hit him up with like a playlist that you love?
No, I just whispered in his ear and said, pick five songs. There'll be different genres.
Pongs.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Look at the little puffins.
I love puffins, aren't
you? There's a little puffin on the TV screen.
Aren't you?
Oh, my whizzy teeth, guys.
Okay, well, let's play this game.
Well, let Dior prep, would you?
Sorry. Sorry, guys. It's inappropriate. No, I've put too much pressure on Dior.
You have. It's disgusting.
Sorry, Dior.
Yeah, you will be.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Why are you taking a photo of me?
Because I felt like it.
Listen, I've told you, that little shrine in your cupboard, it needs to go, buddy.
Why?
Well, because you've got a lot more of my hair than I know it is, bud.
I made my second bedroom into the shrine.
Buddy, this is what we've had to discuss it, haven't we?
Can I have your socks? No.
You've got a heap. That's where my socks are going. I thought it was Steph.
Can I have some more?
Can I have some more?
What do you do when you go, oh, no, you like Taco Tuesday?
Oh, can I go through your bent? Because I know you like Taco Tuesday.
Oh, it's so scary.
Where else do you shave?
That's what you're like, oh, no, you use big razor. You sound like, what's that, salad fingers?
Yeah. YouTube. No, I look like that car, that fella.
Yeah. Oh, no, you like Taco Tuesday.
Oh, it's actually insane when you look back at some of that shit. Like, where the fuck was my brain going?
The ghost impersonations we did were pretty good.
Yeah, I didn't mind.
When we do the duos, we really get into the zone.
Yeah, because it's more of a, we're building.
I'm very good on my own, but probably
tremendous on your
better
own.
With you there.
Tremendous.
Hey, Dior, ever heard of Spotify?
Yeah, I'm ready to go. I'm waiting for you guys to fucking stop dribbling.
So didn't I just, you just got up.
So sorry, Dior.
Jesus.
I haven't had my, I have had my coffee. I haven't finished it yet. I'm so sorry. I take it back. No wonder he's leaving. Both of us. Exactly. Despicable behaviour to Dior.
Can't stand it. Can't wait to get out of here.
No. Yeah.
No.
I'm going to be sick.
All right, let's go.
All right, first song. You want, what, 5 seconds of it?
Yep.
Okay, ready.
I'm just a teenage dirtbag, weenus!
Fuck, that was pretty good. That was pretty good, Lou.
Kid's good.
Yeah, wow, all right. Next one.
No idea.
Play a little bit longer. Feels like a theme song to a movie.
Does it? This one's an older song.
Oh, Elton
Benny
John?
The Jets!
Nah, not Elton John.
Don't know, bruh.
Hang on. Oh!
No. I think that's us done.
Yeah, duh.
That's too long.
That was I Don't Like Mondays.
Oh, I know that song.
Of course.
And I don't like Mondays.
That's so true.
Tell me why I don't.
No, no.
Sorry.
Right.
Well, I don't think we get that long.
No, I agree.
Especially, I think, maybe because of copyright infringement as well.
Maybe.
Okay. Judge, smart.
All right, let's go something a bit newer.
Oh, fucking.
Bitch, I said what I said.
Doja Cat.
That's 5 seconds.
Doja Cat.
Someone know the title?
Doja Cat fucking. I don't fucking know the title.
I don't know the title either, but it's Doge.
Yeah. I get Doja then.
Doja. Paint the Town Red.
Yes.
Paint the Town Red.
Yeah.
Oh, you literally nearly said the lyrics.
Yeah. You started to sing it. Yeah. Got there. Yeah.
The Weezer.
All right, next one.
Dave Dobbin! Dave Dobbin! Slice of Heaven!
Yeah.
What was it?
Blue.
Dave Dobbin, Slice of Heaven.
Day of Jesus Christ.
Yeah. All right, so what's that? That's like 2-1 to Lou?
Yep. Yes.
Tie break. Oh, right. No.
I feel like that one was a bit skewed towards Lou.
I win either
way.
So
maybe. Well, let's see.
Well, let's see. Oh, it's a lonesome away. Slim Dusty.
Mm-hmm.
Who the hell
hold on.
There?
Slim Dusty. And then Fuck.
Come on.
Never heard of it.
Pub with no beer.
Yes.
Slim Dusty.
To all. Slim Dusty. Slim Dusty, one of the greatest Australian fucking...
Oh, I'm from New Zealand.
Still. He rose to international fame.
Okay. I'll research him after the show. Okay, this is a tiebreaker.
It's a tiebreaker. Oh, I got to pick a good one then. One that both of you all know. Let's see.
I've got terrible memory recall, I think.
This will be good for our memes. Memory.
Okay, let's see how this one goes.
Memory.
You ready?
Oh, Eminem.
Eminem. Guess who's back? Slim Shady's back.
No. Oh, fuck. No.
Come on, whoever gets the title wins it. He's back. Tell
everyone. Try the Park Girls Go Round. Fuck, what's it called?
Oh, my God.
Tell everyone. Guess who's back?
Oh, dude. Fucking hell. Eminem. Without me.
Yes.
Fuck.
I had to go through the whole verse in my brain until I got to the chorus. I was just in my brain.
Oh,
like this.
My God.
Yes. I beat her at her own stupid fucking game.
It's not a stupid game.
Woo-hoo! So 3-2. And I am very bad at that game.
Well, I'll be better next time.
You might be. You may not be.
Knowing us, we'll forget we ever played this game. It'll never be heard again.
Correctamundi.
Write that one down, Dior. It's a good game. And then the kids at home can play. The kids, aka the bedwetters.
Bedwetters. Fuck, we love the fucking bedwetters.
I'd like to do these Aussie farm terms you've got for me.
Haven't got any. I forgot that I was supposed to do Aussie farm terms.
We were meant to do it yesterday.
Yeah, but you were like, don't worry about that, we'll do that, blah, 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 blah. And then when you said it this morning, I'm like, fuck, I knew I was supposed to do that.
You are just the worst. I can't work like this. Oh, Jake.
Look, I'm Dothith, sorry.
Well, say three things nice about me. Proper nice.
Didn't we fucking, okay.
Proper nice.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay, all right.
I'm taking these off.
You have very capable shin bones.
And I said proper nice. I don't want to take
these. These are really nice.
No.
Your shin bones hold.
Proper nice. This will be hard for you. Say three nice things about me that you mean. Say it.
You got good teeth, which is a compliment. Mm-hmm. Not everyone has good teeth. Hence why I got braces at 25 years old.
Yep.
You are a human being. Third, what else is nice? The third nice thing. You're out there. You're out here
doing.
So,
just I'm out here.
Yep. So,
okay,
you got good teeth. You're a human being, and you're out here.
You're out here. Just
you got.
Yeah, just doing it.
You know what I mean?
Just doing life.
I thought I'd give you something that maybe you could think about afterwards, and like really.
When I die, I'd like that on my tombstone. She was a human being. She's out here doing it.
Good teeth.
She had good teeth.
Good teeth.
Yeah. Write those down so you don't forget, Dior.
Yeah. Right. Could you? That will be, if you pass before me, which I hope you don't.
Why?
So I can die first and I'd have to go to your funeral.
But I don't want to cry. I don't want to
die. Yeah,
cry.
I know, but sucked in. You're probably going to have to.
Well, that no, will be my eulogy. You're 4 years older than me.
Yeah, but 4 years.
By the time it comes, it's like you're the same age.
Yeah, but I'm a dog.
So am
like
I.
Dog years. You know what I mean? I'm aging rapidly.
So am I.
No.
There's another compliment.
I saw what you were doing. You were trying to fish another one out.
Yeah. Add that to the list.
You are. Oh. That's why you got to dye your hair and stuff. Because you're going grey.
I don't dye. My hair's just got highlights at the bottom.
Dude, you told me yesterday you were like, you've been dyeing all the greys out of your hair.
You're so full of shit.
What? Don't lie to the bedwetters.
Doesn't do his prep and then roasts me about being grey. No, Jack. I've had enough.
Oh.
Can you get HR here?
We don't have HR in this fucking company. Jesus Christ, if we did.
If we did, there would be no employees left.
Well, it would be an implosion.
I'm surprised it hasn't been.
So at uni, did you chip your tooth? tell her.
No, no, I think the bedwetter.
Do you actually have any other good uni yarns or?
Well, now you've put me on the spot.
No, because
Let me have a look in my notes because I write things down because I'm prepared. I have a Google Notes doc.
So I've got my notes, well notes. Right, you know, I've got mine.
Yeah, yours is probably just like one word, you fucking idiot. So sorry.
So.
Oh, actually, we had this landlord. We lived in a house of like seven girls, and we had this landlord. One of my friends just hitchhiked home one day and got picked up by the guy who was our then landlord. He owned this massive like old mansion, and there was seven of us living in there.
Cinema?
No cinema in that house.
You would have been fuming.
Oh, it was. Jeeves came with me, obviously.
Oh yeah, to clean up.
It was fine, and the girls, you know, would make use of Jeeves as well.
Of course.
And you know how like it's illegal for your landlord to just pop over?
He would
literally pop over and go, "G'day, girls."
How old was he?
He's 65.
Okay.
I'm going to call him Bruce.
But he'd go, codger.
"G'day, girls. It's Bruce here," and he'd just wander around the house. I'm like, hey. Pretty sure that's illegal. And he had like a garage outside where he'd always work on his like big like truck car.
Yeah, Brit.
What? What were you going to say?
Well, Bruce.
We gave us a good deal on the house.
Bet he did. Well, you think Bruce was loved his truck a lot, or you reckon there was seven sorority girls
Bruce
in the fucking
house?
Bruce
did love his truck.
Yeah, of course he did.
He was a lovely guy.
Of course.
He was. And then one of our friends drove through the neighbour's house.
Okay, so this is the sort of... Your yarn was, we lived in a house together and the landlord would pop over from time to time. That was your yarn. You've neglected the yarn about someone driving through a fucking wall. Spin that one.
I can't remember what exactly happened, but someone we know, drove through the neighbour's front, like a study.
Accidentally?
Accidentally. I think they just, you know how like you're trying to park and then you accidentally put your foot on the accelerator instead of the brake? One of those and then da-donf.
Straight through it.
Yep.
Fuck it up.
Yep.
Bad.
Yep. But that's what insurance is for, Jack.
That's correct, Louisa. So I'm assuming they weren't happy.
Well, would you be happy if someone drove through your study?
If I wanted a new study, I'd be stoked.
Well, it'd more be if you wanted a new car. You can't really want a new study, you know, you'd probably want a new house.
Or you just, if you're like, if you're, this, you're with your wife, Teresa. You're like, Teresa, this study, it is outdated. Have you seen this wallpaper? I think we need to renovate. Next thing you know, some fuckwit drives straight through your study. You go, hey,
kids
Teresa,
eat.
Mummy and daddy are eating. We're mummy and daddy, by the way. Some fucking dipshit has just run straight through the stud.
Yeah.
Study.
Someone's breathing.
Thank you.
Now.
Do you know, we did this thing back in uni, they banned it. I think we might have been the last year or the year after us was the last year. It was called the Mount Pan Run. It was like a footy thing. Basically what would happen was the second years and shit, like the older boys, they were like the...
Initiation.
It's an initiation, but these guys...
I'll tell you my initiation story after.
There we go. We got the juices flowing.
Yeah, you got it.
Literally, because these guys were like the university version of Severus Snape. They became potion masters.
Right.
So they would develop these concoctions of fucking shit for months. Off milk, meat, fucking like vinegar, fucking
you could get food eggs. Poisoning or die from that.
Well... You don't eat it. Oh. So they'd create these concoctions in buckets and let them just fucking ferment for months and months and months to the point that it was like such a disgraceful stench. It'd make you gag just smelling it. Anyhow, so we'd all have to go up the top of Mount Panorama. Strip off. So you're starkers, fully naked. The guys would then fucking... have these concoctions of buckets, initiate, you'd stand there like this, they'd pour the shit all over you with food dye and fucking all this other shit. So you are stinking, sticky, filthy. Then you've got to do like, it was like a 3 kilometer run. So you run from the top of the mountain down to the footy fields. And as you're running down the mountain into the footy fields, they all jump in their cars. They're loaded up with eggs and they just fucking pelt you with eggs the whole way down, like fucking proper welting you and shit the whole way down to the footy. Like, it was fucked. It was actually a lot of fun. I don't know if you've ever, like, run down a mountain naked, you're, like, jumping.
But also...
cocks flying everywhere, like, and you're just, like, you...
Obviously, that's a fucked story, but it's sad that now no one would get to experience uni like we did.
I know.
Do you know what I mean?
I know. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Because a lot of it's online now. A lot of these kids do online.
Yeah,
and I'm just like,
you can't get away with anything.
And look, there are elements of that shit that is fucked up. If a kid really didn't want to do it, they were almost forced to do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, that's
and that
not
shit's
okay.
Bullshit. But... if you were a willing participant, I think that shit's... like, the coppers used to monitor it.
Yeah.
To the, like, the coppers were okay. They knew it was happening. They'd tell the cops. The cops would monitor it.
Yeah.
And come and get a peek of our... also, I think it was midwinter. So
they'd be shriveled.
You're not looking great.
A little razor.
You're not looking great. But one year, a kid got blinded by the egg.
Okay. Well, see, there's... you've ruined the story.
No. I think we were wearing glass. We ended up wearing glasses.
Goggles.
Yeah, maybe goggles.
We had initiations as well in Dunedin to go from first year into your university flat on Castle Street. Which
had to chip your tooth.
You know how Dunedin is Castle Street? So it's like the Scarfy Street and they light the couches on fire and it's fucking loose. It's like,
no. Oh,
it's literally like the street party and the houses are disgusting, but everyone wants to live on Castle Street in your second year. And so you have to get initiated into the flat. Like, so the girls or guys before you will initiate you. Our one, we arrived and they made us put our bra.
Oh, I don't need this on anymore.
They made us put our bras on the outside of our T-shirts.
Yeah.
Then we had to take all of our makeup off, slick our hair back into a tight, low, like, bun with, like, grease. Then we had to put last person we'd slept with something else, like, all over our cheeks. And then
yours was last person to provide a wristy to, obviously, the wristy community.
Correct. and then we had to do all these, like, fucked up things, like smoke a ciggy as fast as we can with no hands. So you go,
we
had to eat a can of beans, like not like baked beans, like cannelloni beans, like, and you're blind drunk at this point, by the way. Then we had to do, like, a running race and we're, like, drinking at the same time, then eat a block of cheese, I think it was.
Oh, Mama's loving that.
Yeah, I was like, hey, this ain't punishment,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, yeah.
This is
Jesus
amazing.
Jesus Christ, beans and cheese. Are you serious, kids?
And then we're, like, very drunk, and then everyone gathers around. Like, I'm not even kidding. You're probably, like, 200 people in this backyard, and we've had to go into, like, a back room of one of the rooms and create a dance. So there's, like, five of us blind drunk, and we're doing, like, some weird dance performance for, like, 200 people looking like that. I've got a photo of it. I should find it and put it
up. I'd love
you
to find that.
We're like on the grass. Like, it's just, it was wild back then, the shit you could do. Like, yeah. It would never happen now.
Yeah, no. The shit doesn't fly now.
The boys' ones, to get into the Eight Man, which was like the main flat in Dunedin, that was like the cool, you know, like everyone wanted to be in the Eight Man. They'd like shave their heads and shit. Like, everyone's head was shaved. Like, they'd be on display. Like, 300 people would come and watch it. Like, it was... the initiations were wild. And then I think probably 2 years after we'd all been there, that's when the uni cracked down. They started to buy all the houses on Castle Street.
Really?
Like, just fully, like, obviously way different back then, and some shit was obviously pretty fucked up, but, like, they just ruined it for everyone. Like, it's not like it was. Even before I went, there was a place called, I think it was it Gardies or Garden Bar or something, and it was so loose, and that closed down the year before I got there. Like, it was just the loosest place.
True.
Yeah, wild.
You know, when I was out at the Colli pub, I met a bunch of birds from Rob College in Armidale.
Yeah.
And that's sort of from around, I went to school in Armidale.
Mm.
The college was always, like, the uni was always loose as fuck, like Albies and Rob and that. They were gnarly colleges. And I was yarning to them, and because I've spoken to people who have gone to Bathurst after us, and, like, I think there's only two colleges left. Most of it's online. It's like, it's completely decimated.
Yeah.
I was actually, they were telling me yarns and it sounds very similar.
Yeah.
So in Armidale, it lives on. And I was like, this is really nice to hear, girls, that this shit still goes on. We're also sponsoring the women's rugby team.
Yes.
The Rob College.
Is that their school?
Yep.
Amazing.
Yep.
Yeah, we're sponsoring.
So, fuck yeah, that's a bit of living. We mean well, repping
for
the
Rob. So we'll go up there.
We'll go up there, we'll get Lou up to the farms.
It's got to happen. I need to see my sheep.
But darling, you have been so busy.
No, but Jack, I have. It's just...
we can't get you up.
How many times did you go to the gym today? Was it morning and arvo? And did you sauna ice both times?
Darling, and that
and then did you box?
No, but seriously.
And then wait? Yeah.
And that's flat out.
And then did you not look at your phone for the rest of the day and not reply to anyone's work stuff? Yeah. Did you turn off your notifications for WhatsApp? Because that's worse.
I don't have. No, hey, can
hey,
I turn. Hold
I
on,
know.
On. Can I ask you a question, though?
What?
In my pursuit to try and get better at communicating.
Yes, good.
Can I turn on notifications just for one chat?
Yes, and you've got to do it for We Mean Well and for We Mean Well Production.
Okay.
Because that, you got to, it's a, I know we don't think it is, but it's a job.
I know.
It's a business.
Correct. All right, I'll do that after this. You do that for me.
I will. I'll do that for you. Now let's play Red Light, Green Light.
Sorry?
Well, I told you that's what we're going to do.
Wow, she's bossy.
Yeah, well, have you prepped for that?
Nah. No. Yeah, I have.
Should I start?
Well, you start.
Okay. Red Light.
No, give us a fucking jingle, kid. Oh, are we going to go into this segment jingle-less?
No, Jack, I am. I profoundly apologize.
Louisa.
I profusely apologize.
Yep.
I'm notoriously good
don't
at,
fucking
at jingles, just like Aristotle.
And Descartes. Plato.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I loved Plato. I used to eat it. It was salty.
Okay.
I'd probably still eat it now.
Not Play-Doh.
Oh.
Plato.
Wait, did you really think Lou? I was like, oh, that's good from Lou. That's a funny joke. But no, she was being serious.
That was slick. I'm like, oh, she's got a bit of wit about her. Yeah, I love Play-Doh. I used to eat it. Okay. All right. Not what I was talking about.
I'm so sorry.
That's fine.
I'm so sorry to disrespect Plato.
That's fine.
I apologize to everyone.
Okay.
I'm going to go home and reflect.
Please do.
I will.
Now, give us a jingle in the style of Frank Sinatra.
Can you give me a little tap?
Yeah, let me just.
Red light, green light on. We may eat well.
Okay, that was toilet. That, but from both
look,
of us.
Look, Jack,
from
I'm already going to reflect today.
Sorry.
Just, would you?
I apologise, Louisa.
Stop. Okay.
Righto.
Red light, green light. Fully grown men saying, I need to go wee-wees to their mums.
Oh, what the fuck? Green? Are you serious? How funny would it be going, I'm doing that when I get home tonight.
Yeah, go.
I'm going to go. Oh, Mum, I need to go wee-wee.
She probably wouldn't even flinch.
She wouldn't, to be honest with you.
So one
no, that's obviously a red.
One,
by the way.
A red. One of my friends dated a guy and they
God,
what?
This is not real.
No, it's fucking real. You know the girl as well. Dated a guy and they'd been dating probably like 4 or 5 months and they went back to the mum's house for the first time and, you know, just general kind of chit chat.
You're joking.
And he goes, I need to go wee-wees. That's like how he says he needs to pee to his mum. Just go to the bathroom. You, like, I need to go wee-wees? Are you a 3-year-old toddler with a diaper who needs help?
Nappy.
Are you fucked?
What the fuck?
I need to go wee-wees.
How could she root him after that?
Well, it was, like, it had been, like, 4 or 5 months. Like, they were in a relationship.
No.
Like, it was past the point where you can get the ick and probably pull
hold
it
on.
Out.
Run me through it. Can I get a bit of a fucking picture painted about this bloke? What did he do for a job?
He was a bit younger.
What was his caper?
In finance.
God.
Like,
fuck.
Mate, you do stocks and bloody shares and spreadsheets. Surely you can piss on your own.
But even...
I need to go wee-wee.
Even announcing... So the fact he felt the need to announce to his mum that he's got to take a piss. If you're like, oh, mum, I've got to take a piss. I'd still sit there and go like, why did you just fucking tell your mum that? Even if you said it normally.
I get
but if
it.
You said, I need to go wee-wees.
Yeah. I just go, I need to pee, or I'm going to the bathroom.
But just go.
Yeah.
You
don't
know
need
what
to announce it, that you need to go wee-wees.
Bruh, that's a wild yarn.
When she told me we were on a walk, I was like in tears, and she'd go on and tell other conversations. Then I'd just go, ha, sorry, we need to circle back. I need to go wee-wees.
So, yeah, could you just hold that thought for a second? I actually need to go wee-wees.
Yes. I actually do need to go wee-wees right now.
Do you?
Yeah.
Well, go on.
No, it's okay. I'll hold on.
Fuck, this is what she does for you bedwetters, mate.
Yeah.
She's willing to piss the couch.
I'm ready to piss.
Just to fucking...
Sorry, I'm ready to go wee-wees.
Okay. Red light, green light. 2-month trips to Europe.
Well, Jack...
Red light or green light?
I would say that's a big old green.
What?
I would say going to Europe for 2 months is a fabulous holiday. In fact, I did it last year.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I went to Europe.
For 2 months?
Well, let's call it 7 weeks.
Okay. And then what else did you do that year? Oh, you'd done, obviously, the 10 days in Thailand. Taken another month off as well. So I think last year you would have worked 8 of the 12 months.
Look, Jack, you've got to reward yourself sometimes.
Can I be honest with you?
What? No, you've put your foot down. I'm only allowed to go for a month this year.
Correct.
I'm fine with that.
I love that. You're very receptive.
Yeah.
But do you – this is my way I – this is just me personally. Mate, after like 3 weeks, I'm like, I'm over it.
Oh, I'll genuinely, when it hit the 4 week mark, I was like, I'm pretty over living out of a suitcase. I don't want to feel ungrateful, but I was quite ready to be at home in my routine.
Mate, it's like a lot.
You know how you hear those people who do like surf trips for like 4 months? I'm like, how?
Yeah. At
not
least,
for me.
Yeah, I just, I've realised I like travelling, but I hate travelling. I like being somewhere.
You're not much of a holiday guy.
Well, no.
You're like a four-day holiday kind of guy.
Kinda. It's weird. Yeah. When I was working at night, like I used to fucking have.
You used to work at Nova.
Sorry, let me. Have I not told you this, darling? I was one of the most tremendously deplorable employees at Nova Entertainment. Yeah.
That's so interesting. We both worked there.
We did. The things you learn.
You do learn when you do a podcast with a friend.
But yeah, usually. There was a point there where I hadn't sort of had a like gone on a holiday for, well, an overseas holiday. I hadn't been overseas for 7 years.
Yeah.
And I just because if I'd had a holiday, I'd take a week and I'd go back to the farm and fuck around or like, I don't know.
Mm.
With the first,
there's
yeah.
something about,
I don't know.
Something about Europe that hits diff.
But if I go back there, because I went over for my mate's fucking wedding a couple of years ago, that was mad.
Well, we're going to go back this
But it was
year.
Just, I'd rather just go over there.
Why don't
and
we
spend
do
a week in one spot and then a week in another
That's
spot.
That's what I do.
Go,
why don't we do
home.
The podcast from over there? Imagine how much fun we'd have in Mykonos. Yes.
Yeah.
Come on, I'll call Steph. She'll be in.
Yeah, well, fuck it. She will be fucking in. Yeah. Don't you worry. So please don't call her.
Because my plan is I want to do Greece, Italy, and Portugal. So I'll do literally a week in each. And then I'll do see my brothers in London.
Yeah, see, I want to go and see like castles and shit.
I want to be blind drunk by 11 a.m. on Aperols on a day bed.
Yeah, I like that element too, getting fat and tanned, drinking piss.
I'm going to do Mykonos and Ibiza.
This year?
Yeah, with Tor and I.
Mate, I don't know what I'm fucking...
I think you guys should come. Mm. Even if you just did 2.5 weeks. Imagine us doing the potty over there.
Okay, let's just figure that out.
Okay, we'll chat after
we'll
this.
Chat, we'll chat, yeah, mate.
But yeah, you've put your foot down. I'm only doing a month this year.
The poor thing's only got a month off in the
middle
of the
year. No, Jack, don't, please, it's okay. I'm okay with it.
I'm sorry about that.
No, it's fine. It's so fine. Red light, green light, running for public transport.
That's a ripper.
I know.
I'm green.
I'm orange. Because it's like...
I'd love to see you run for a bus.
That's what I mean. And with a backpack, if you're going to miss the bus, you're going to miss the bus.
I have a theory that you'd be a goofy runner.
Want me to show you?
If we don't have enough space.
I could just run back and forth.
What has this become? Yes. Well, go this way. Go okay. across. But you won't get enough speed.
Hey. They don't call me Fast 2 Feet Delden for anything.
They don't to call you...
Well, do now.
Okay. Okay. Yep. What are we doing? What are we doing? Yeah. But it's not enough to get the full... I'd love to... Okay, hey, can we do something
race?
After this?
Yeah.
Can we go out on that street and I want to film you full tilt?
Sprinting.
A fucking oath. Like full, as fast as you can go.
You know, this will actually come to a surprise to everyone. I was a very good sprinter as 8-year-old Lou. I'm actually not kidding.
Oh, fuck this
one. I'm actually not kidding. For a big little girl, I was a very good sprinter.
How good?
Like, would win the 100-meter races sometimes. Like, it would be first place to third place. It was bizarre.
Who were you competing against?
Small children. You want to call Jill and ask?
Obviously a lot smaller. No. No.
Why?
I'll tell you why we won't call Jill and ask.
I think we should.
Because Jill will say, yes, darling, you were a phenomenal sprinter. You were a phenomenal sprinter. And we used to call you.
Headphones on.
We used to call you our little Usain Bolt, even though he wasn't around then. And we just loved it.
Put your headphones on.
Oh, here we fucking go.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
Hi.
Good. Quick question.
Yeah.
Was I a very good sprinter at age 8? Like, I used to win the 100-meter races, didn't I?
Absolutely not. You know you didn't.
Jill, I was a good sprinter.
Jill, I love you.
Mum, I was quick for a fat 8-year-old.
Just to win the race. Jill, this is incredible stuff. Jill, this is incredible stuff,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah, I thought it would create great content for you.
I am proud of you.
Mum, I'm certain I was a good sprinter. I'm offended.
You're a fraud is what you are.
Hello.
Jill, I was a good sprinter, wasn't I?
Jill, thank you.
Oh, she's hung up on us.
Jill, fuck yeah. You know what? I feel like maybe I've got through to Jill in some sense.
Maybe we call Franco and just...
No, we don't. I think, you know, because you talk a fair bit of fucking bullshit.
Judge, like, trust me, I was...
No, you
weren't. I wasn't a bad sprinter. Jill's got it wrong. Franco came to the games.
Oh, okay, love that. Okay.
So why would you
why would you try and call Jill?
I knew Franco would be busy.
Sorry? We just spoke to him.
And he said he was at work.
He was fine.
He was in the car busy.
He was happy for a year.
We weren't going to have someone else on speakerphone on the podcast.
Jillian just gave you a little dose of reality, kid. You weren't a sprinter, okay? You weren't a good sprinter. I reckon me at age 8 could beat you in a running race at you age 30.
Probably, you scrawny little rat acne fuck.
Okay, she's got her feelings hurt. She didn't get the answer that she wanted, and now she's...
Play the
hotline. She's lashing out. She's lashed out, and it's hurt my feelings. Okay, I just don't know if I can do this anymore.
Stop.
I love that she's just fucking gone. Nah, fuck it, not today. No, you weren't, Lou, all right? You weren't. You can't colour in. You weren't a good sprinter. You can't sing a fucking note.
Why were you listening to Rihanna?
I was feeling nostalgic, put on a 2000s playlist and I was jamming.
Hey, sounds like you and I could drive home together. That's what I was listening to, champ.
Was it?
Yeah.
I'm just feeling...
2000s mix.
Do you know what I've been feeling lately? I'm not going to get into it too much. I'm not liking a lot of new music coming out.
Yeah, I'm actually the same as you, Jack. I've got a playlist called Oldies, and it's like, you know what was on it? Lionel Richie. Oh, not long.
Banger.
Fucking banger.
Just
probably one
back
of the greatest
into some
songs.
Good old shit, you know?
Yeah, good old shit.
You know what I mean?
I do know what you mean, actually.
I've really got back into Collision Course, Linkin Park and Jay-Z. Fuck me dead. Every cunt calling me. Fuck. Sorry, Toes, mate.
Your penis flytrap videos hit 40,000 likes.
Shh, you got me timbers.
And we're at 1.2 million views.
Okay, there we go. All right. Should we do this?
Yep.
Give us a hotline jingle.
Oh, for God's sakes, you just use and abuse me. Hotline, yeah.
God, that must have really taken it out of you.
It did, Jack. I'm flat out with jingles. All
right.
Also, I've just thought of a good idea. If any business would like me to make a jingle for them, I'm DM and I'm happy to make one on the podcast. That's a great idea.
Okay, I like it.
Imagine it's not like a tattoo parlor or like a plumbing company or something. Hey, I'll plumb yours if you plumb mine.
Well, sorry. I mean, there's no need to get into pure debauchery.
So sorry.
Let's see what this bedwetter had to say, eh? That's a good idea. I like that.
G'day, you fucking bedwetting sons of bitches. Just a fucking little question here for you from, one of the best. Why the fuck is it okay to piss in the pool, but it's not okay to stand outside the pool and fucking piss into it? I've been caught that many fucking times doing it. I'm fucking over it, all right? Normalise pissing into the pool.
It's actually...
No.
Keep pissing, you fucking dog.
Keep pissing, cunt.
That's incredible.
No, no.
Bye.
There's two very evident reasons as to why there's a difference. Number one, it's the acknowledgement. You don't acknowledge you're pissing in the pool. Everyone lives in that blissful ignorance, that pissful ignorance.
Yeah, and everyone goes, I don't piss in the pool. Yeah. You're pissing in the pool.
Ignorance is piss, as they say. Number two, let's say you're at I'm at the Walker pool. There's some 8-year-olds learning to swim. I then proceed to remove my genitalia from my pants and piss into the pool. That is called public indecency. Yes. When you're in the pool, you don't have to remove said appendage to piss.
You're right, Jake.
You know what I mean? Right. Yes. Those are the two first ones that come to my mind.
You're not telling anyone you're pissing.
You're not telling anyone.
It's just a little secret between you and your bits.
Yeah, correct. All right. Let's see what this bed fucking mate really appreciate. I hope that clears that up.
Yeah.
Okie doke.
Jacqueline Edwina Archdale. I thought you were an absolute wordsmith, mate, but here you are on episode 77. No! Missing a supreme opportunity. We're talking about Joe's fucking Lulu's disgusting black toenail. Jeez. And you decided that maybe you'd pop it into a tequila bottle like the scorpions and the caterpillars. And you said, oh, we'll call it toenail tequila. Mate.
Tequila.
You missed out on calling it toquila.
You're an idiot.
Disappointment, mate. Keep pissing.
Absolute idiot.
Yeah, fuck it.
I'm a disgrace.
You are. It's despicable.
Tequila. And when he was done, it came to me. When he began to pull me up. That's for the thing.
No, these are my snacks.
Oh, okay. I'm so sorry.
Give me another.
Give me two more. That's a ripper, mate. That's a good point. And I do apologise. I will try and be better.
Yeah, you should try and be better. I'm sorry? It's disgraceful.
Oh, my God, I really hope this is the right number. So I'm calling from New Zealand, and it took me a fucking long time to figure out how to do it because I'm just really, really smart like that. But I was on Hinge, and, swiping through, and then I see a prompt of a guy saying, Lou and Judge, tell me to fucking download the app or whatnot. And I was like, I replied because that's the first
from our head.
But, yeah, that's my cool story for... and you better fucking play this. I'm going to be absolutely pissed.
Pissed?
I hope I'm not just leaving a voicemail at a random thing. Okay, bye.
I wish you
did. Doesn't that show that our bloody ads work? You said Lou and Jarch told me to download Hinge. Dior, time code that and send it to Hinge.
100%. Also, we're generating love. She matched with him because they were both bedwetters.
We are the modern day Cupids.
Correct.
You could call us Jupid and Lupid.
It's not bad.
It's very good.
I'm not mad at it.
Yeah. You're not happy with it? You're orange.
I'm orange.
Okay. I'll take it.
But it's good. Happy to be out there generating love for the bedwetters. I mean, that's what we're fucking here for, so.
Give me one more.
Okie dokie, smoky fucking shaky. What do we got? Let's bloody do this one.
Okay.
G'day, lads. Hope the sound's all right, Lulu, because I'm parked, but you are going through my new car because it's a Suzuki Vitara. And the reason I'm telling you that is because I just saw Lou's parking on her Instagram story. And I have to tell her that I relate. Huh? I went from a tiny little fucking, I don't know, little shit car. And now I've upgraded to a bigger car and I cannot fucking park it for shit. Only thing, though, is, Lou, why don't you fix it? Why don't you just reverse back and fix it? That's the only thing. It gets me. Anyway, Judge, you're hot as fuck. Lou, you're also hot as fuck.
Okay. Holy dooly.
Loving the compliment. She knows how to give a compliment. You don't.
Tires are sufficiently pumped.
Same. But, like, I'm already in the park. If I'm just dipping in somewhere, there's no point changing it.
Such.
Like that one I sent yesterday.
That is such a Louisa Dalton attitude.
Hey, Judge, that one I sent yesterday was like, I'm going to the post office for 4 minutes. Who the fuck's going to hate me for 4 minutes?
Me.
Well, you already hate me, so
no,
say lovey.
Lulu.
Say lovey.
I love you, Lou. And guess what?
Ugh.
You've got tremendous bone structure.
Yeah, and I'm out there, and I'm a human being.
You're a human being.
And
your
shins, got great teeth.
Your shins are holding up. And I reckon you've got tremendous ligaments.
You're so sweet.
Thank you.
That's just Jake.
Well, I've been told I should write poetry.
Yeah, well, write me an acrostic. Is that the one where it's like L stands for? Yeah.
Okay, I can do that.
Luisa, if you're wondering how to spell my name because you're an idiot.
I'm an idiot.
Yeah.
G'day, pot. Kettle.
Kill. Nice
once
to
again,
meet you.
Lovely to fucking meet you. Righto, you sweet, sexy bedwetters.
Okay, we love you guys. Mwah. Hey, don't forget, last few days to vote for Triple J Hottest 100. We want Nerdy Bra or Doing Time. If you just vote for one, Nerdy Bra, go to our Instagram and it'll show you how to vote for it because you've got to do it manually. But we want to hear Nerdy Bra or Doing Time or both on the Hottest 100 Triple J.
We would love it, you know, because it just would be a game changer. And that's life, man.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to get an indigestion.
That's okay, sweet angel.
Okay. Love you guys. Hooroo.
Bye.